downtown Riyadh, Saudi Arabia, with Lieutenant St. Clair and the group from Escon Village, going downtown and Christmas shopping. And it was probably the most unique Christmas shopping experience I've ever had, driving around in a bulletproof SUV.
Yeah.
And that was probably one of the most special memories I've had.
That was very
one of the most amazing things was to come from a small city like Warwick, Rhode Island, and ultimately end up in the Middle East. It was single-handedly the most important thing I've ever done, will ever do. But I think the one thing that kept it in perspective for me as we were coming, I think it was from the Saudi Arabian airport, driving down the freeway, of which there's no posted speed limit. So was to look at the side of the freeways, and, you know, periodically you'd see a few, you know, cars that had been in wrecks and whatnot. You'd see a Kentucky Fried Chicken and a McDonald's, and then up on the horizon, you'd see a pack of like 10 camels hanging out together. So it was very strange. And for the first 3 days, I kept it to myself because I thought I was the only one that witnessed it. But yeah, that's my story.
Every troop that we have over there is very, very dedicated to this country and dedicated to the ideals that it stands for. Honesty, integrity, and they are over there with honesty in their hearts and with all good things in their mind, and they honestly want to change things, and they approach things on a daily basis with that in mind. And just to be welcomed into that culture, which was something that I had never experienced before, really opened my eyes to what the military is and what it stands for with this country.
Sure, when you're lost at sea.
be here in 29 Palms. I'm Ashley J, and these are my guys, and we are here to play some country, some oldies, and a whole lot of rock and roll. Just take those off.
Hilker.
What's your first name?
Jason.
See, you guys forget you have first names.
Here's my known as no one else on earth. Looks like it's going around.
to bring up somebody who has helped me out throughout the day and last night getting this whole thing put together, and that is Staff Sergeant Lipinski. Please come up here on stage. All right, guys, get it. He knows what to do.
Well, I was up all night. It's a little too late. When you want me, I should have walked out. But it's a little too late. Watching the right thing now.
Now you're gonna do that, okay? Next time, a little too late. Do the right thing now, okay? Oh yeah.
Oh well, the hotel told me you're a heartbreaking king. Yes, I ought to pay attention when they say those things. But it's a little too late.
He's a great dancer, huh?
I know I'm old, but he's gonna help me out. But it's a little too late to do the right thing now.
All right.
I ring the jukebox up with a sort of stand. A jukebox does turn his heart around. I may be wrong, but I don't want out.
Do it. Well, it's a little too late, yes.
Singer.
All right, so I'm gonna sing this next one to you. Is that okay?